going on, everybody? It's your boy Rashaud Mccray, realtor here in North Carolina. I'm actually broker with J Park Carolina Living. I have my own subdivision, One Dream Property Group, underneath that. We're here today. We're at Meritage Homes, and we're gonna check out this beautiful home. Pass it over to my boy Trey. Let him do his introduction.
So I'm Trey. I'm with Meritage Homes. I'm a sales consultant. Today I'm gonna take you through the Lockwood model. This is one of our most popular plans. It's a little over 2,400 square feet. It's 5 bedrooms, 3 baths. So come on, let's enjoy the tour. So Rashaud, as we go through this model, you can pretty much see this is a really open floor plan.
Sure. I like it.
You have your kitchen opening up to your family room. One thing that's really cool about what we're doing right now is that all appliances are standard. So all homes come with refrigerator, a washer, dryer, and blinds as well.
That's better than most builders. Some builders can't get their hands on all of that stuff right now, so that's good. All usually stainless steel are you going with?
All stainless steel. One thing I really like about our builder is that with all homes, it comes with the gas range.
Okay.
People really prefer this over the electric range.
Yeah, they do. They do. I work with a lot of buyers right now. I'm trying to get into the listings, but I just can't help the fact that buyers are coming to me often. Gas range is probably top of the list. Open floor plan for sure, granite countertops, and this gas range. I just people love the kitchen.
So a big thing about how we build out here, everything is all inventory. So we use something called a live now process, where it's designed to be more affordable, it's designed to be transparent, and you pretty much know what's coming in the house ahead of time. So you, within our packages, you have your countertops, you have your cabinets, you have your flooring, and you have your carpet as well. And we have 6 different packages.
All right, so is this it downstairs or?
So another thing about this home is that it has a bedroom downstairs. So this home offers a full bedroom. As you can see, we turned into an office space.
Oh, yeah, that's what
you have
need,
the ability
right?
to do. A lot of people are using offices now just because of what's going on with coronavirus.
Yeah.
But again, we do have the space for a bedroom.
I love the setup in here. It's just, it reminds me of, like you say, it is a bedroom, but people need to convert these bedrooms into offices now. People working from home a lot more often. So yeah, this is perfect. The setup kind of brings it to life.
And then you have a full bathroom right here to your right.
Got the marble floors.
Full bath. So Rashaud, as we go upstairs, do you notice the difference between the temperature downstairs and the temperature upstairs?
No change at all.
The reason is because of this spray foam insulation right here. So
okay.
This is what sets us apart from other builders. We put this spray foam insulation in the attic, and we also put it along the exterior walls. It's designed to help you have a more comfortable home. It's also designed to help you have a healthier home. It keeps out dust, pollen. Do you have allergies or your kids have allergies?
Nah, but a lot of my buyers do.
A lot of your buyers do. I have allergies. So it's going to help you with that. And along with that, it's also going to help you save money on your energy bills.
Now, okay.
Like, everybody wants to save
who
don't money.
Want to save money? Who doesn't? Area up here. You got your spray foam insulation. You're comfortable in your crib. Check out the master bedroom.
Let's go. So Rashaud, as we go into the master bedroom, I really love that you have a sitting area right here.
Yeah.
Be very creative in what you do with that.
Come here, come read a book or something.
Read a book, entertain me, put the TV up here.
Can't put a TV here. Yeah, this is dope. I love the setup, man. Y'all staging, it gives a buyer who comes in a really good idea how they can stage a room.
Right.
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
I see you're a pretty fly guy. A lot of people, you know, I don't know much of clients, but clothes is important. So the good thing about this home is you have 2 different closets. You have a his closet here.
Okay.
You have a hers closet.
So what's how you gonna say this his closet?
I just figured she has more.
So he get the small closet.
He get the she small get the closet.
Wow. Okay. Nice open bathroom. Countertops. I'm loving the white countertops. The white cabinets.
So you do a quartz countertop.
Yeah.
This is throughout every single bathroom.
And your master.
Oh, yeah.
floor. We have the washer and dryer here as well. That's standard.
Standard washer and dryer. Large laundry space too. Mm-hmm.
Secondary bathroom.
Quartz, white, flooring.
Three more bedrooms. A lot of my buyers really like that the master and the secondary bedrooms are separate.
Opposite on the opposite of the house. Side. Yeah. Just because you got something going on over there and nobody got here over here. Usually, when I show my buyers the three separate bedrooms, mm-hmm. especially like guest bedrooms, I kind of zoom through them because usually they're pretty standard. Yeah. Really, all they want to do is see is how is the size of them, because sometimes your guest bedrooms have different sizes. These ones have pretty good closet sizes, I noticed as well. So, sound good.
Hey Trey, man, I want to thank you so much for showing me around in your Lockwood home.
Appreciate you for stopping by.
For sure. I would just quick question, man. What, uh-huh. If my had buyers that were interested in something like this, what price range are they looking at?
In this particular home, I have two available right now. One of them is around $350, the other one is right around $360.
Okay. And payment wise, that's usually pretty important to my buyers. Would you, mm-hmm. rough estimate where I would get them?
So it really just depends on if they're going conventional or if they're going FHA.
True.
Also on their credit scores. But based off of FHA, you're probably looking at somewhere around $1,900. Go conventional on this and put 5% down, you're looking right around like $1,800.
Okay,
that's right. That's without, you know, HOA fees and things like that, but it gives you a rough estimate of what it's gonna be.
Some people paying that in rent or more, so to get a nice house like this, that's perfect. Okay, all right. Well, you know, it wouldn't be right, man, if I came all the way this way and I ain't break bread with you, man. So let's go take it in the room, man. Let's break bread. Let's go. All right, man. Well, I wanted to sit you down, man. Just kind of ask you a few questions. Not so related to the real estate market industry, so to speak. When it comes to success, what's your definition of success?
Man, my definition of success is really simple. It's just one's ability to achieve their goals in life. Mm-hmm. So whatever that may be, a lot of times, even for me, you might not achieve your actual goal, but waking up every day to get closer to your goal than you were the day before, while also, you know, putting in maximum effort every single day. To me, that's success.
To you, you could be successful on a daily basis.
On a daily basis. Every day, if you go harder than you did the day before, if you maximize yourself, in my opinion, you're successful.
I like that. What do you think separates you from your competition? I know you like an all-star, man. You damn near made it to the Olympics. A complete competitor, in my definition. What do you think separates you from your competition?
I think that it's still the going based off of what I said about success, mm-hmm. is my will to want to grow to be better each day. Mm-hmm. I'm always competing against myself. So I can never really win. So all I can do is either get better, and if I don't get better, I go back to the drawing board and see what I can do better. Mm-hmm. And so if I can see somebody that's better than me, I take that as something I try to learn from them.
Yeah.
And then I try to attack myself every single day. I use them as a measurement to enhance myself, to try to be better than them, but at the same time, again, it always goes back to growing in some way and outperforming myself.
See, it's funny you said that. I got a lot of the same philosophies when it comes to how do I beat my competition or how do I make myself better. But to me, I always look at it like, if somebody did it, I know I could do it.
Right.
Like, they set the standard to let me know. You tell me somebody sold 100 houses in 1 year, mm-hmm. I need to sit down and have lunch with them and see how they did it. Because I could do that if they did it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. That's usually my mentality, so that's cool. All right, so it's 2021 now, and I don't know if you noticed or not, but Realtor.com brings Charlotte the third highest market right now. So third hottest market, number one being Sacramento in California. Number two being another place in California. I forgot what number two was, but number three is Charlotte. So it's two West Coast. You get way back over here in Charlotte. With it being so crazy, man, I know it's moving so fast. There's not a lot of inventory in the market. Even with new home sales, like a year ago, I could bring a buyer to buy a new home, and the process seemed so much easier. Mm-hmm. Now it's like, yo, if you miss a couple hours, you may not get a house.
No.
So my question to you is, what's the craziest story that you have with a buyer either coming in and just lucking up and getting a house at that right time, or even a buyer that thought they was going to get a house and ended up losing it because of the timing?
Yeah, I've seen both scenarios out here recently. I've seen a lot of buyers come out here, like something, call me later on that evening, and the house is gone.
It's gone already.
It's gone. So I've been trying to do my best at giving them all the information they need in order to make a decision right then.
Yeah.
And that's what the live now process with Meritage Homes is designed give the buyer every single thing they need to be able to make a decision before they leave.
Okay. So marriages are, they forward thinking.
Forward thinking.
Yeah. Meritage homes, you guys offer different incentives, right? Mm-hmm. When a buyer does come and purchase from you?
So one thing we offer that's really cool is we do $8,000 in closing costs if you use our lender. That to me is highly important just because to me buying a house and not getting the closing costs, that's almost like money I'm just throwing away. I look at
closing costs as fees. I hate paying fees. I hate spending my money on fees. So if you could tell me somebody could pay my fees for me, that's money. It doesn't go towards equity. It's just a fee.
It's just a fee.
Yeah.
So that's the biggest thing that I like about Meritage Homes is that we're able to pay at least $8,000 of your closing costs.
Most of your closing costs anyway.
Exactly.
Okay. That's cool. Real quick, man, if we had to leave our viewers with something to learn about, or if you had a quick tip, just for everybody that's watching, man, just drop them with a jewel.
I'm going to go back to what I said before about success. I think everybody should focus on growing each day in every single way, not only with your goals and your business or professional-wise, but with your family, with your body. Every single day, how can I get better? How can I be a better version of myself? And I think we all need to focus on doing that while staying in our lane and not focusing on everybody else.
Yeah. I like that.
Keeping God first. That's the first thing. But I think just having that mindset of always focusing on growth through anything, it allows you to be better in any position. Whether you're for a realtor, you focus on how can you be better with every single buyer that you meet.
Yeah.
You know, you can't go back to what you did wrong yesterday. Go back for a second, learn from it, and see what you can use to be better tomorrow.
Going forward, yeah.
Same thing with the buyer. I think every single buyer should try to educate themselves to the best they can before they make that decision to buy a home.
Mm-hmm.
So it's universal.
Yeah, I like it. Okay. All right, man. Well, that kind of wraps up the show. I thank everybody for watching. Be sure to hit that bell button above so that way you never miss a video. Hey, man, I would dap you up and shake your hand, but you know the corona, but we could do the air pound for my boy, man. Again, man, Rashaud Mccray and Trey McRae.